a few words about the museum. I will first show you a few pictures of this museum to know what it is. So, as you see, I have my bad English with text, it's better, can read. And you see this is a new architecture of this museum, think by Rudy Ricciotti, which do this museum in a special concrete we knew called béton fibré ultra performant. You see, it's two bâtiments, a new one, which is here, and the Fort Saint-Jean, where you have few bâtiments used as museum. So one new, one old. Beton's ramifié in English. Rested in this basement is so. If I come back, here you have, I come back, here you have down auditorium, first stair, Mediterranean Gallery, I will talk about it, temporary exhibition, and here a platform with restaurant. After, you have this bridge, I will show you. So you see the platform with restaurant here, and this bridge, which you see the old bâtiment and the new one. So you have an idea of what is this museum now. So I will talk to you about the half temporary exhibit. One curator of a Canadian museum said, what is a permanent gallery? It's a gallery who stay too long. So this gallery is half temporary change and has been changed one time since I talked about you. So I have a challenge when I think to this museum. I have only 1,700 square meters for talk all about Mediterranean. And by example, during 10 years, in 1999 until 2009, during 10 years, many people try to think about what to show about Mediterranean and Europe. And fail. And I arrive in 2011, and I have only 2 years to think about this project. So, my opinion, and I will read you the principle of this museum. The Mediterranean is an area of civilization. The Mediterranean etymology, the inland sea, only form a political entity during the several centuries that the Roman Empire existed. Since then, in spite of all the imperial fantasies that aimed at establishing themselves around this shore, the Mediterranean area has never attained unity. But in spite of this event of homogeneous political, social or religious entity was never reached, the Mediterranean area is one of the most fertile civilizations in existence, on a par with the China Sea, the Indian Ocean, the Mesoameric, around which different cultures had developed. In the area of the Chinese Sea, race-based civilization evolved. Elsewhere, they were based on corn, whereas the Mediterranean saw the expansion of wheat-based civilization. The way in which Mediterranean world participated about 10,000 years ago in the spread of different forms of Neolithic eclosion is amongst others one of its singularities. The salient feature constitutes the founding principle of Gallery of the Mediterranean dedicated to inland sea. So I'll show you first what is common to each cradle of civilization. By example, stone, to build something with stones is everywhere. You have stone, you have rocks, you have this kind of building. Other one is mummies. You have mummies in Inca civilization, mummies in Egypt, mummies in China. Other example, really important for me, is the writing, the script. Here, Sumerian, sorry. Here, Sumerian, Mohenjo-Daro in India, Chinese, but Maya write script, and probably Egypt script, it's not impossible, is invented in its size and not coming from Sumerian civilization. So you have many common points between all those cradles of civilization. I built the Mediterranean gallery. It was impossible to begin with Sumerian, continue with Greek and Phoenician and other. It was impossible to do that in 1,007 square meters. So I propose to think the Mediterranean as a cradle of civilization between the other and develop singularities of this cradle of civilization. So I propose, as I think first one civilization I told you about is the wheat-based civilization. It's based on the wheat. It's a specific from Mediterranean civilization, different from the other. And I think what is also common to all Mediterranean and make Mediterranean cradle of civilization different from the other. And I propose, no, here you have the map, you see, in violet colors, you have wheat, you have rice, you have beans, and you have, you see, the different area of civilization, how they borrow. Alors, that's important, this other map, I just will told you, is I think humanity known only two, human being, know only two big revolutions. That one, when we hunters became peasant, and the other one we live today, when peasant became citizen. So, the first singularity is that one. The about called invention of agriculture and born of God. Why born in of God? I think when I talked, it's a revolution when hunter became peasant. It's not only a material revolution, it's also a spiritual one, and I will explain. Man, harnessing nature, places himself above it, and therefore imagine beings above himself. Thus, the birth of the gods, reflected in the small animal sculpture and effigy of God presented in the gallery. Previous mode of thought are replaced by a new one, analogical thinking. The bull god, the Sumerian tablets, and his consort, the co-godless, and are succeeded by an infinity of pagan deities to which temples are dedicated. This mode of analogical thought leads to place a cult of culture where men live massively settled lives, places dedicated to the supernature, temples, domestic, altars, sacred spaces coming from this place of nature that a large number of nomadic farmers regularly menace sedentary societies concentrated around the city. Between the 6 millennium before our area until one century ago, the Mediterranean area lived to the rhythm of the advance of farmers cultivating crops and raising cattle while exploiting existing resources. So you have four singularities. The first one is about agriculture and God. Now you understand, I hope, why. So that's those two maps. And here you see the first gallery, part of the gallery, with, by example, a sakye for water coming from Egypt, and which is really important because of the sedentary sterilization, because the first movement, the pluri-secular upwheel of the Mediterranean ecosystem, the advance of the farmer and the breeders, confronted with the difficulties of nature are fragile. Because of the sterilization of the plateaus linked to the practice of abatis burned, by the first farmers, people grouped together in the valleys of the Great River, where more than 5,000 years ago, the civilization of Pharaonic Egypt and Sumerian cities were born. But I think also in Indus and in Yangtze, big river, is the same phenomenon. The sakye exhibited in the center, here you see here, the sakye, exhibited in the center of the gallery recalls the edge of this water-based civilization and the great importance of fresh water in the Mediterranean world, where natural irrigation is often insufficient and marked by sudden alternation. So, with this sakye, we talked about the first agriculture and the long time of agriculture. By example, this is for stock wheat. It's a Crete one object. And we finish this part of the gallery with the bread, and we have in our collection bread from many countries of the Mediterranean. The sakye, you see the detail. And so, what are the other singularity of Mediterranean? I propose, and I'm sure that's not on the only one, for one. The second, which seemed to me evident, is monotheism. It's not so evident at all because, in fact, you have, by example, Akhenaton and Moses long time ago, but you have Siddhartha Buddha in Extreme Orient. So it's not so easy to say it's only civilization. Monotheism, sure, is in Mediterranean, but a spiritual revolution exists also in Asia. So if we think about Abrahamic religions, it's typical Mediterranean. And we chose to show monotheism only around Jerusalem, because we have not enough place, and Jerusalem is really important. So here, by example, we show pieces from the different holy places. Holy Sepulchre, El-Aqsa, the mosque, where Mohammed go to the sky, and objects from the wall of the temple for Jewish. And in this gallery, so that's by example, and a Jewish object will show the wall of the temple. That's a model of the Holy Sepulchre coming from the 17th century. That's the object who show the sacrifice of Ishmael for Abrahamic for people. That's the sacrifice of Abraham for Jewish people, and that's the sacrifice of Abraham for Christian people. We have three ways in this gallery, one for the Jerusalem of past, with the Jerusalem of the prophets. Here you have a Muslim painting, sheet painting, show Maria. But you have Jesus, you have Maria, you have Mohammed, you have Moses. That's time, the pastime of the prophet. The Jerusalem of the present is the Jerusalem of pilgrim and pray. And Jerusalem of the future is for the three monotheists, Jerusalem of the end of time. That's like this, that structure, this gallery. And you can go from one point, which is a place of holy places, to the other one, which where are the book who talk the story of these holy places in an installation from a contemporary artist called Michelangelo Pistoletto. And here you have a place for Buddhists because this is installation. Here you have a place for Jewish Bible, Torah, Christian Bible, and Quran, and nothing here for people which are agnostic. So, the second singularity is about citizenship. It was for me a big question, is citizenship really born and specific of Mediterranean? I can answer you today, democracy is all over the world. You have pre-democratic society, by example, in America, where India have assembly and decide war of peace in assembly. So you have all over the world many people which have kind of democracy. But the idea to connect citizenship the democracy with the city is Greek. So we talked about citizenship. We show, by example, two models, one of Babylon here, and one of Athens. What is a city without citizenship? I'm sorry, what is a city without citizenship? It's only temple and palace. What is a city of, with citizenship as Athens? You have theater, you have agora, you have boule, you have many things for citizenship. Here, I saw the symposium of Greek, but I will go quickly. Here you have a magistrat to this image. At the center of the gallery, you have another strong idea. Many museums talked about citizenship, but when you say maybe that's an history of citizenship, people said you, antique citizenship don't have to be connect with the modern citizenship. And I not agree with that. That's why we do this presentation. For me, the question which is at the beginning of citizenship and we stay until stay today is that one. How is it possible that the other, which is not as me, can have the same right than me? It's true for Greek people, it's true today if you think about. So to show this, we do that. Here, this is the role of citizenship. Here you have portrait antiques from Fayum, from Asia, from other parts. Here you have portrait last century. And here you have a big wall with nine ladies talking about their experience of citizenship, one from Egypt, that one from Israel, one from Tunisia, one from everyone of this lady. Why ladies? Because in front of them you have the symposium for Greek citizenship, and it's only men. And it takes a long time for people can think, yes, ladies are different from men, but nevertheless, they can vote and they can be citizenship. So modern lady answer to the old macho men. So that's in this parts for citizenship. You have one about Greek, born of citizenship and more citizenship with Roma. So laboratory of citizenship, city of Mediterranean during Middle Age and Renaissance, example Venetia, but also Marseille. The time of revolution, beginning with Corse, where the constitution of Pascal Paoli, continue with France, and we evoke a Spanish revolution. At the end, we have a thinking about where are we today with the human right, with the International Declaration of Human Rights. And it's a question because many people say human rights is for Occidental, but other cultures don't have this view of human rights. And we answer in the gallery with a text, medieval text of Malia, African people, says we need the respect of the body. And we think, I have 5 minutes, so it's okay, I will finish in 5 minutes. And we think in the gallery that everybody wants the respect of the person. It's not specific of Occidental culture. So you have here guillotine, which is death punishment, and say first right is a right to the life. You have a part of the Berlin Wall showing with Israeli Arabic Wall to say freedom to go from one part to another is one of the man of the right of men. So we have many things about, we are thinking about the right of man, and we finish this part about citizenship with a video of Cristina Luca, which is a Catalan artist, and show freedom guide leading the people from Delacroix in a movie, but freedom go down and everybody try to kill her. So the last, because we have not to finish with a pessimist view, the last part is an event, is around an event when Vasco da Gama arrived in India, and it's beyond the known world. So we were really afraid to go on sea because it was really frightening, and the mermaid is a, before understand was really a symbol of this frightening. even if we have a curiosity cabinet, cabinet des envies, where we show porcelain, silk, aromatic plants and many things Europeans want to have because it's really important for commerce, and that's why people go to the other part of the world. By example, this is noix de muscade. And here you have the laboratory of discovery with the map, with the instrument, with the boat. And the boat is San Gabriel, on which Vasco da Gama arrived in India. Really small boat, if we think to Zhanghe, which have huge boat 1 century before. And we show how built at the end the image of Mediterranean with, by example, with this popular view, or with a contemporary artist, by example, this milieu de table from Les Poiriers evoke heritage of Mediterranean in Rhin. Thank you for